My idea of a nation. In 1948, when India had just woken up to life and freedom, A.Z. Fizu, who introduced himself as a spokesperson, wanted India to set free the Nagas. In his letter to C. Roger Kopalchari, he wrote, "We occupy a territory at a point of confusion, and we cannot permit Naga territory to be political plumbings, which curbs the formation of Naga National Council and gave sustenance to the Naga movement." And coming to my idea of a nation, I believe it all boils down to nation building. And speaking of nation building, I would like to start up with first the concept of patriotism. Patriotism is a love for nation, enacted with an action of selflessness. It means sacrificing our life, our blood for security, freedom, and integration. A nation is formed with a motivated patriots like Fizu, who says, "I am a Naga first, a Naga second, and a Naga last." Second, unity. After the signing of Shillong Accord in 1975 in the name of NNC, no doubt Naga has split into various organizations, from National Socialist Council of Nagaland in 1980 to NSNIM and NNCNK in 1988 to Naga National Political Groups, etc., with various visions respectively. For example, NNCNIM proposed for shared sovereignty, yet Naga would not merge with India, whereas NNPG has no issue with the existence under Indian sovereignty. This shows the existence of dissenting voices and doubts among Nagas. The 70 years of patience and struggles and the 23 years of peace talk would be successful if we adopt the concept of we Nagas cannot be divided. If we are not united, we will fall. Imagine 2.4 million of Naga population coming together as one and standing as one. I believe we can build an inclusive nation that is Kugnalim. Third, a flag and a constitution signifies a nation. There is no nation without a flag and a constitution. If the government of India has recognized the unique history of the Nagas and that we were never conquered, it is the right of the Naga to have a flag and a constitution. Fourth, a socialist and a democratic form of government. A nation of democracy where there will be no interplay of many to ensnare the voters to elect the representatives. A socialist nation where there is equality and no division of classes. A society where there is no corruption. Fifth, education. A nation is not only a geographical boundary, it is an idea that must infuse in people's mind and must burn as a pride in our hearts. But we don't know about Andalan War, the Second World War and the Nagas, and a lot of achievements of the Nagas. We only know the negotiations that is going on over a decade. We never learn even a line on Naga movement. Therefore, a syllabus must be included on Naga movement in the subject of the mother tongue so that the youth understand the history of the Naga and adopt the quality of ownership and leadership. Sixth, gender equality. It is a fact that Naga society is a patriarchy society. However, the position of a woman in a nation is an accurate asset to the development of a nation. Any development strategy that neglects the enhancing role of a woman cannot lead to comprehensive social and economic development. Therefore, it is important to address women issues and empower women to have an inclusive nation. In conclusion, a nation means I stand here and make things happen. A nation means you and me. And I believe if all the Nagas come together despite the differences of the tribes, we got a common spirit of one nation, one Naga, I believe we can have an inclusive nation that is Kugnalim. Long live Kugnalim. Thank you.